discussed about the proves that is gentleman of Rio and Medio for the 10th standard students. So in this class we will continue, and what we have discussed in the last class is, so the old man, so he came to the so the room, the discussion room, he came that place. So he is looking like the poet is comparing him to the many people, that is for example he compared him to the Charlie Chaplin, and so he is also compared him to the senator. Understand? So we will continue here. There was a great deal of conversation about Ryan and his family. So usually many people, they are in a room, or they are in a group. What they are usually discussed? They are discussed about their family. They are discussed about, obviously, Ryan. So what about your side? What about your side? So for the Ryan, what about the crops? Which crops you are growing now? So those discussions we can see in the people when they are in group, when they are in met each other. So they are discussed like this. Here also the same thing happened. So the group of people, they are gathered in a one place. So in that discussion they are discussing about the Ryan and his family. He was very proud of his large family. So many people are gathered there. So they are like family to the old man. So a big family, a large family of the old man. So he had the family, those people, he was treating those people as a family. Finally, we got down to business. Now finally, before that, the people were discussing about the Ryan and their family, and the old man was very happy because of that big family. Now, all of a sudden, they came to discuss. They came to the main thing, that is a business. Now, they are discussing about the business. What is that business? Let's see. Yes, he would sell, as he had agreed, for $1,200 in cash. Yes, finally, the old man, he decided to sell his land to others. He decided and he agreed for the $1,200 for that land. Understand? So he agreed and he decided to sell his land to the other people for the $1,200. Okay. The old man, he decided to sell his land to the others for $1,200. Now, in cash, we would buy, and the money was ready. So now, the people, who wants to take that land, so they are talking. So, we are ready to buy that land, and the cash is ready now. We are going to give the cash and you have to give me the land. So they are the people who bought that land. So they are demanding in front of the old man. Don Anselmo, I said to him in Spanish, we have made a discovery. Okay. So that Don Anselmo. So here the writer is, it's himself is a speaker. The writer who is written this prose, he was the writer, he was the speaker in this lesson. Okay, so he was the speaker, the prose writer. He told to the old man that in a Spanish language, he told to the old man that we have made a discovery, we have made an investigation, we discovered something new. So the speaker here said to Don Anselmo, you remember that we sent that surveyor, that engineer up there to survey your land so as to make the deed. So here they sent the speaker, the people who are ready to get the land, those people. So they sent a surveyor or they sent a engineer and engineer to that land to survey that land. And when they are discovered something, well, he finds that you own more than 8 acres. That surveyor, that engineer, so they discovered the old man, he belonged more than 8 acres. So they discovered that land. He tells us that your land extends across the river and that you own almost twice as much as you thought. So you told us that I want to sold this land, I want to give this land to others. But when we sent to the surveyor or the engineers, they told that you have the twice land. So they said like that, these Americans, so as much as you thought, he didn't know that. And now Don Anselmo, I added, these Americans are Buena Gente. They are good people and they are willing to pay you for the additional land as well at the same rate per acre. So that instead of $1,200, you will get almost twice as much and the money is here for you. So here what was happening, the land, the old man, he wants to give the land to the other people. Means others means Americans. So that land, the old man, he decided to sell that old man's land to the American people. So that the Americans sent a surveyor or an engineer to survey the land. So when they are survey the land, so they discovered a new thing, that is that land is more than 8 acres. So it is in 8 acres more when they are discovered that matter. So again here the speaker told to the old man that, so that is 8 acres, more than 8 acres land we can see in that place. So that the Americans now they decided to give you more than $1,200. So that for each acre, so as they want to, the Americans, they are ready to give more amount to the old man. And the money is here for you. So finally, Americans decided to give the money more than before. So now they are ready to give the more amount because that land is more than 8 acres land. So that they decided to give the money more than before they talked. Means that is before that they are decided to give $1,200. Now the Americans, so they are ready to give more than $1,200. The old man hung his head for a moment in thought. Then he stood up and stared at me. Friend, he said, I do not like to have you speak to me in that manner. I kept still and let him have his say. So the old man, he bore his land and then he said, so for a moment he was thinking. So that old man, he just bore his hand and he was thinking about something. And then he stood up and stared at me. He suddenly stood up. He stood up and he was looking. Stared here means, so look towards the speaker, towards the author. He stared to the author and said, so he called. So the old man called to the author or the speaker as a friend. He treated him as a friend. Friend, he said, I do not like to have you speak in that manner. I don't like your behavior. You should not talk in that manner. So that is not a good manner. You have to talk in a good manner. So The matter completes. He was wait. Who wait? The speaker waits till the old man's saying is complete. Next, Americans are good people. Yes, old man is also agrees that Americans are good people. And this is why I have agreed to sell to them, but I do not care to be insulted. Okay, yes, I also agree that Americans are good people, so that I have decided to give the land, but I do not care to be insulted. So when the Americans decided to give more amount, what they agreed, so now they are used to give more amount. So when the old man, he thought that he was insulted by the Americans. Okay, so now he was telling that, so please don't insult me. Okay, you don't talk in that manner. So talk me very softly and talk to me very so truly. Okay, don't insult me. He said like that. I have agreed to sell my house and land for $1,200, and that is the price. So indirectly, what the old man was telling, so I don't want the more amount. So I have already told you that. So I'm decided for the $1,200 for the land. So that now also you have to give me the same price. I don't want the more amount what we have taught. I argued with him, but it was useless. The speaker argued. He continuously argued to the old woman, but that is useless. There is no use of the argument. The old man did not accept their price. He decided his price as $1,200, and he want that amount only. He don't want the more amount. I have agreed to sell my house. So finally he signed the deed and took the money, but refused to take more than the amount agreed upon. Okay, so here we can call him gentleman. We can call the old man as gentleman because of this good humanity. So if someone demands us to give more amount without any second thought, we just agree and we can take the amount what we discussed or what we talk. So but this old man, he reject the more amount. So the Americans, they are decided to give the more amount, but the old woman did not accept. He want the $1,200, only $1,200 for that land. And he took that amount and he agreed to take that amount only. Then he shook hands all around